Hey everyone, Jake from 8020 Automotive here. Today we are talking about cooling fans and more specifically how to diagnose a bad cooling fan. Cooling fans are extremely important for helping reduce engine temperatures to make sure that your engine doesn't overheat, because overheating can lead to some very serious internal engine problems and can even cause complete engine failure. So making sure you have a working and efficient cooling fan is extremely important for preventing serious repair bills down the road. In this video, we're going to go ahead and talk about cooling fans and more specifically the difference between mechanical and electric cooling fans. And then from there, we will talk about signs and symptoms of a bad cooling fan and finish it off with a diagnostic checklist that you can go ahead and follow through step by step to diagnose and fix your problem. So the purpose of a cooling fan is very simple. It's to help reduce your engine's temperatures, but it doesn't do that by just blowing air at your engine. The primary component responsible for cooling your engine is the radiator. The radiator is where your engine coolant flows through, and the radiator cools down the coolant, which then passes through all the passages within the engine, ultimately cooling the engine down. But the issue is radiators are not very efficient when your engine's moving at slow speeds or idling and not moving at all. So when your engine's not moving or moving slowly, we need to go ahead and aid the radiator and provide the radiator with that airflow. And that's what the cooling fan does. The cooling fan creates airflow and blows the air through the radiator to help increase the efficiency of the radiator. And that ultimately leads to lower engine temperatures. So the purpose is the same, but there are two different styles of cooling fans. The first one is a clutch fan and the second is an electric fan. So a clutch fan or a mechanical fan ultimately is driven by the engine. It has a clutch on it that is attached to the accessory belt. So as the engine turns, the accessory belt turns and that turns the clutch that therefore then turns the fan. So ultimately the fan is spun by the engine and the clutch is what determines whether it is engaged in spinning or disengaged and not spinning at all. And then on the other hand, we have electric fans. Electric fans use an electric motor that gets power from the battery, and that electric motor is what causes the fan to spin. That motor is going to be controlled by the engine's ECM or the engine's computer, and so it's not going to be driven off of the engine like we have with mechanical clutch fans. This allows electric fans to be a little bit more precise, but the caveat is that because it's now an electric component, there are a handful of additional things that can cause it to fail. So with that being said, let's go ahead and jump into the signs and symptoms that you'll experience when your cooling fan fails. So when your cooling fan fails, you will most importantly experience engine overheating. One of the best ways to tell that it's the fan that's the issue is you'll likely experience the overheating when you're idling or driving at low speeds. The second thing is going to be a noise coming from the fan. If you hear any weird noises coming from the fan, it's a good sign that either something's happening with the blades or maybe the clutch is engaging or disengaging properly. Third, we're also going to experience weak air conditioning when idling, and that's because the fan is also responsible for helping cool your AC condenser. So if your air conditioning is weak or gets a little bit warmer when you're idling, but then it gets colder when you're cruising at highway speeds, that's a good sign that your fan's not working. Fourth, we're gonna have fluctuating engine temperatures. As I mentioned, you know, when you're idling, you're gonna see those temperatures start to rise. As you're driving at highway speeds, you'll have a steady flow of air going past the radiator, which is gonna help reduce engine temperatures. And so if you have a lot of fluctuations in engine temperatures from when you're idling to when you're driving on the highway, that's also a pretty good indicator that the fan is not working. And the fifth thing on here is just visually seeing that the fan is not spinning when you know that it should be spinning. With that, let's go ahead and jump into what causes these fans to fail, because that will be very important for the diagnostic steps that come next. So with a mechanical or a clutch fan, the primary cause of failure is going to be with the fan's clutch itself or the clutch assembly. The clutch is what's responsible for engaging and disengaging the fan, and because it is a mechanical part, there's not a whole lot else that can cause it to fail other than the clutch going bad. Typically, that's the only thing you have to worry about with clutch fans. But of course, as I mentioned, electric fans are driven by a number of other components. With an electric fan, you're gonna have to look at other things like your fuses or your relays. You've got the electric fan motor, which usually is integrated into the fan assembly. In addition to that, we've got coolant temperature sensors or various different electrical or battery related issues. And so because there are a number of different components that can fail on each of them, it's important to talk about diagnostic steps based on whether you have a mechanical clutch fan or an electric fan. So if you have a mechanical clutch fan, there are two different tests that you can do to try to test if the fan itself or the clutch in the fan is bad. And that's going to be by doing a spin test, where you're actually gonna spin the fan with your hand, which of course means you should do this when the engine is not running, because you don't want the fan to turn on while your hand is down in there. The first test that we're gonna do with the engine off while the engine is completely cold. So do this, you know, after you haven't driven your car for a really long time. What you're gonna do is go ahead and try to spin the fan manually with your hand. You should be able to spin the fan freely because the clutch should be disconnected. If your engine's cold, the engine's turned off, and you do have a lot of resistance trying to spin it, that means that the fan clutch is bad and it likely got stuck, engaged, or locked into place. And then that brings us to the hot test. So what you'll want to do is go ahead and drive your car around, get it up to operating temperature, and then turn it off, and then try to spin the fan. Because the engine is still hot, the cooling fan should have a lot more resistance as you try to spin it. But ultimately, when it comes to mechanical cooling fans, they are a little bit easier to diagnose, in the sense that if the fan's not working, it's either not spinning at all or it's always spinning. An always spinning fan is not good either. And if you do have an issue with your fan, the only way to fix it here is to replace the fan itself. So now let's go ahead and talk about electric fans. We're gonna go ahead and talk about diagnosing this from easiest down to the hardest. The first thing that you're gonna wanna do is check your fuses and your relays. So go ahead and pull out a fuse diagram and see which fuse is responsible for the electric cooling fan, and pull that and see if it's bad. And if it's bad, replace it, see if it works. Second, you're gonna wanna visually inspect the fan and make sure that the fan is actually running. A mechanical cooling fan can always be stuck on. But when you have an electric fan, if something electrical fails on it or the motor itself fails, it will never spin. So if you have a fan that doesn't spin, even when your engine is at full operating temperature and idling, then that's a pretty good sign that the electric motor has failed, or you've got some type of electrical problem causing it to not spin, such as a bad fuse or a relay. A third thing that you can do is you can use a scan tool to try to manually engage the fan. If it's not turning on, that again is gonna point to either an issue with the fan motor itself or the electrical. So if you've already checked the fuses and the relays, that's going to mean that it's getting proper power. As long as you don't have any issues with the electrical wiring that's running all the way to the cooling fan that connects into the battery to provide it power, then the last thing that ultimately we're left with here is an issue with your coolant temperature sensor. You can use a scan tool to monitor your live coolant temps, or if you have a coolant thing on the dashboard, you can go ahead and look at that and see if you see any wonky numbers coming from there, or see if it's not working at all. Because if your coolant temperature is bad and the engine thinks that it's cold, even though it's very hot, that will prevent the fan from kicking on as well. Ultimately, before you go and replace the fan completely, you wanna make sure it's not a fuser or a relay, and you wanna make sure that your coolant temperature sensor is good as well. If it's not one of those two things, then you'll need to go ahead and replace the fan. In most cases, the fan and the fan motor are integrated together, and so you'll likely need to replace the whole assembly. But if you do for some reason have one that has a motor that's not attached to the actual fan, then you can go ahead and replace that too. So that covers it on our video on cooling fans. Hopefully this video was helpful in diagnosing the issue that you're having with your clutch fan or electric cooling fan. If you guys appreciate this content, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for all the future diagnostic content we have coming.